is the moment he's directly in love with you.
With him? Why, 'tis not possible.
Mark me with what violence she first loved the more. But for bragging and telling her fantastical lies. And will she love him still for prating? Then after the discreet heart thinking, her eye must be dead. And what delight shall she have to look at the devil? When the blood is made dull, the accurate sport, there should be again to inflame it and to give satiety a fresh appetite. Loveliness in favor, sympathy in years, manners in beauties, all which the more is defective in. Now, for want of these required conveniences, her delicate tenderness will find itself abused, beginning to feed the gorge, disrelish and devour the more. Very nature will instruct her to it and compel her to some second choice. Now, sir, describe who stands so eminent in the degree of misfortune as Cassio does? A knave very voluble, no further conscience, than putting on the mere form of his civil and humane seeming, for the better compass of his soft and most hidden loose affection. A subtle, slippery knave, a finder of a teaching that has an eye can stand on counterfeit advantage, though true advantage never present itself. Besides, the knave is handsome, young, and that all those requisites in him that folly and green minds look after. A pestilent complete name. And the lady hath found him already.
I cannot believe that in her. She's full of most blessed condition.
Let's be said. The wine she drinks is made of grapes. If she had been blessed, she would never have loved the more. Blessed pudding. Didst thou not see her paddle with the palm of his hand? Didst thou not?
I did. But that was but courtesy.
Lectury, pardon, sir. An index in obscure prologue to the history of lost and found thoughts. They met so near with their lips that their breaths embraced together. The villainous thoughts were recall. When these mutualities so marshal the way, hard at hand comes the master and main exercise, the incorporate conclusion. Pish! But, sir, be you ruled by me. I have brought you from thence. Watch you tonight, for the command I lay it upon you. Cassio knows you not. I'll not be far from you. Do you find some occasion to anger Cassio, either by taunting his discipline or speaking too loud, or from what other means you please, which the time shall more easily acquire. Sir, he is rash and very sudden in choler, and haply with his truncheon may strike at you. Provoke him that he may, but even out of that will I cause these of Cyprus to mutiny, whose qualification shall come into no true taste again, but by the displanting of Cassio. So shall you have a shorter journey to your desires, by the means I shall then have to prefer them, and the impediment most profitably removed, without the which there were no expectation of our prosperity.
I will do this, if you can bring it to any opportunity.
I warrant thee. Meet me by and by in the city. I must fetch his necessaries ashore. Farewell.
Adieu.
That Cassio loves her, I do well believe it. That she loves him, tis apt and of great credit. The more, howbeit that I endure him not, is of a constant love in noble nature. And I dare swear he'll prove to Desdemona a most dear husband. Now, I do love her too, not out of absolute lust, but partly led to diet my revenge, for that I do suspect the lusty Moor hath leagued jealousy so strong that reason cannot cure. Which thing to do if this poor trash of Venice, whom I trace for his quick hunting, stand the putting on? I'll have our Michael Cassio on the hip, abuse him to the Moor in the rank garb,